probably knew, Carl had to guess at it, but it wasn't much of a guess, John chapter 12. And I want to thank my two sons and my three great men of God who were here last Sunday. And I heard they did a very good job. So those people who worry about once I go home, whether there's somebody to take over, we got it covered. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I'm thankful for that. Now don't worry, I don't plan on going home soon. But if I do, you know you're covered. Hallelujah. Don't you laugh at that, Chris, because I said, that boy, that's something else. Go get it. That's my friend. You know, one of the things I want you to realize, we're going to pick up a little bit from the Sunday before, and I want you to think about this again. The resurrection is the fullness of the gospel. Without the resurrection and believing in a risen Christ, you don't have your full salvation. You know, if you just come into the cross every morning, repent of your sins every day, and you never think of the fact that the grave was empty, you have missed the fullness of the gospel.
Right. Yeah.
Because what confuses the world is that a man raised himself from the dead.
Right.
They got all kinds of examples of people who say they rose, but this man, Christ, had witnesses to the resurrection. Many witnesses. And many saw his death on the cross, including unbelievers like the Roman soldiers who killed him, or the Jewish Pharisees and Sadducees and religious who accused him falsely. But as they watched him die, they didn't know who they had killed. But the resurrection put a seal on who he was. And the ascension made it clear. You ever saw a man rise up to heaven in the clouds? Today I want you to know he also will raise you up. And he raised up Lazarus. And because he raised Lazarus from the dead to show you the power of the resurrection. This is the reason when he entered the city that day. That's the reason why they decided to kill him. Because they say all the people are following him. But they were following him because they also wanted to see Lazarus. Because they knew nobody could raise the dead but God. After 4 days, even the Jewish doubters who were there that day, they knew that Lazarus was good dead. But Lazarus didn't stay in the grave. That miracle went all over right before what we call Palm Sunday. And so the people were flocking to see him because they knew he came to the temple on certain feast days and certain times. They were all looking for him because he raised, say it with me, he raised the dead. Jesus said to Lazarus' sister, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. You know, he's trying to show you and me, I don't have to wait till I die and am buried and raised again to raise the dead. He's telling you and me, I have life in me already. And I have the power of the resurrection. So those people doubt that he was really God. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. You didn't have to die to raise the dead. He had to die to bring you into eternity. Because you can be raised. Lazarus was raised, but Lazarus didn't go up to heaven. He wasn't ascended up. But Jesus was. But I want you to see, in him is life. Say life.
Life.
Eternal life.
Eternal life.
So when he came in that day, he didn't come in for himself. He came in because he knew what he had to go through for you and me. He had those palms put before him and those branches put before him and the people praising him, not because he was God, because he can raise the dead. And we still believe in him, and some of us do not believe the dead are raised. But if you don't believe that, you don't believe the gospel. sad to say, half of the word is not good enough.
That's right.
You need the whole gospel.
Yeah.
Oh, the people of the world, and especially during that day, they didn't want to leave evidence of his resurrection. The one thing they didn't want Christians to talk about was not that he died. People die every day. The Romans crucified a lot of people, buried a lot of people. But only one was raised from the dead.
That's right. Hallelujah.
See, that's the one they don't want you to be happy and joyful about. Because they want you to stay at the cross, repenting of your sins every day, all day long, sweating out your sins. Been there, done that. Still doing that. At least I am. I'm not sinless. Every day I got to get before the cross. But I'd be still bent over by the cross if I didn't understand the resurrection.
Hallelujah.
But the people in the city, they had to fulfill what was preached in Zechariah. Jesus came to fulfill everything the Old Testament said. Don't throw your Old Testament away. He came to fulfill all of the Old Testament.
Yes, yes.
Zechariah 9:9. I want y'all to turn to John 12 because I'm home now, so y'all might have a long time to preach on today. Sorry. Zechariah, you don't have to turn to Zechariah, I'm just going to read a little bit of it. It says, your king comes righteous, having salvation, gentle, riding on a donkey's coat. Jesus had to fulfill that. So he sent him into Jerusalem to go get that little coat and bring it to him. Now I want you to concentrate on a little coat because you see, some of y'all want God to do big things now. You see, when he comes back, he's going to be on that big horse that they talk about with a sword coming out of his mouth.
Yeah.
But he came in on a donkey's coat.
That's right.
Not even a full-grown one. Feet dragging on the ground. He didn't look like a king. But see, you got to start somewhere. See, the little bit God's doing in your life right now, what I want you to learn to do when this message is over is to thank him for those little bits.
Yes. Yes.
Because the little bit gonna be something big if you're thankful for that. Y'all better understand what I'm saying. I've lived that. My children have lived that. We were afraid. I was more afraid for Sonya's life than the baby. And the devil tried to make a deal with me, and I'm like, no, I want the whole thing.
Yes.
I want the baby. I want my daughter.
Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah.
I want the whole thing.
Yeah.
He said, he'll tell you right quick, I give you a daughter, but I may have to do this. I give you a baby. I'm here. No deals with Satan. Don't you do deals with him.
No.
God can do exceedingly abundantly
above all
you.
Yes.
God will give you just what you ask for.
That's right.
Just keep on believing. That's right. And like the song said, keep going forward.
Yes.
Yeah. Today I had a testimony that Jesus Christ has risen. And next Sunday we'll celebrate that. But I want you to remember, he raised Lazarus. He has life in him already. Yes. He said, I am. Somebody say, I am.
I am.
The resurrection.
Resurrection.
And life.
And life.
That's it. So he didn't have to die to bring life. He was healing and doing all kinds of things, raising the dead before he died. But when he died and he rose again, he proved he was more than just a man. He was God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Listen, if you think a man can raise the dead, ask some of those doctors and some of those funeral home directors. I mean, they saw walk out of it. But those who believe in him, we have what? Eternal life. Listen, John chapter 12. And I want you to just have a little bit of thanksgiving in your heart for the little things God's doing as I preach this message, okay? John chapter 12, verse 1. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus arrived in Bethany, where Lazarus lived, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. Here a dinner was given in Jesus' honor. Martha served while Lazarus among them, who those reclining at the table with him. Now that, just imagine, Lazarus sitting down eating now, 4 days in the grave. Now if you think he's still dead and he's sitting down eating, you've lost it.
Come on, man.
I'm sorry. Then Mary took a pint of pure nard and expensive perfume. She poured it on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But one of his disciples, Judas Iscariot, who was later to betray him, objected. Why hasn't this perfume sold and the money given to the poor? It was worth a year's wages. He did not say this because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief as a keeper of the money bag. And he used to help himself to what was put into it. I have personally witnessed Judas in my life. Leave her alone, Jesus replied. It was intended that she should save this perfume for the day of my burial. You will always have the poor with you, but you will not always have me. Meanwhile, a large crowd of Jews found out that Jesus was there and came, not only because of him, really with me, and also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests made plans to do what? Kill Lazarus as well. Why? For on account of him, many of the Jews were going over to Jesus and putting their faith in him. Mm-hmm. Listen. So the next day,
Next day.
Y'all with me? Mm-hmm. The great crowd that had come for the feast heard that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. They took palm branches and went out to meet him, shouting, read it with me, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel. Listen, Jesus found a young donkey and sat upon it, and as it is written, do not be afraid, O daughter of Zion. See, your king is coming, seated on a donkey's coat. At first, the disciples did not understand all this. Only after Jesus was glorified did they realize that these things had been written about him and that they had done these things to him. Now the crowd that was with him when he called Lazarus from the tomb and raised him from the dead continued to spread the word. Many people, because they had heard that he had given this miraculous sign, went out to meet him. So the Pharisees said to one another, see, this is getting us nowhere. Look, read it with me, how the whole world has gone after him. Why? Because he raised a man from the dead. But they ain't seen nothing yet. Nobody had to raise him but his father. But the resurrection of the dead is a powerful testimony to Christians. It's that testimony that the world just cannot believe. When you're dead, you're dead. But Christians have that eternal hope that when Jesus entered that city, he was going to open a door to heaven for us to be alive again. When Jesus died on that cross, he was going to take our sins away. When Jesus was raised from the dead, he was going to raise us up the same way to eternal life. Listen, you got a lot to be thankful for. You have to start off with the little things in your life. The little babies in your life, so tiny you're scared to hold them. You got to be thankful for those little things that God has done that you see. The husband that you think is not perfect, but he's done all of the things I need, 90% or 50% of. He does so much more. Or the wife that has done the little things that she get for you, cook you cookies in the middle of the night and bring them hot, piping to you. It's the little things in our lives that we learn to be thankful for. That job you hate, that give you a check when you need it. That job you can't stand, that pays your bills. See, we don't know how to be thankful for small things. We're so anxious for the big ones.
Yes, Lord.
Today, I want you to know Christ didn't come in on a big white horse, mm-hmm. coming out the clouds. He came into Jerusalem on a donkey. Mm-hmm. A donkey. You wouldn't have done that. You'd have got the best little Cadillac going to walk and come in there and be all those people adoring you like that. But they were adoring a man whose feet were dragging on the ground, practically, riding on a donkey. But Jesus knew that when he returned, he was coming back in glory. He came to be a servant. He's going to return victoriously. Today, I want you to hear the good news of the gospel. I want you to have the whole power of the gospel. Not just the crucifixion, but the resurrection.
Yes.
Jesus said, I have life in me. If you live in him and move in him and have your being in him, you should have life. When the devil tried to make a deal with you to give you death, you say, no. I'm going to choose what? Life.
That's right.
I'm going to speak life. Death and life, the scripture says, is in the power of the tongue.
That's right.
He doesn't want you to know you can be healed. The devil doesn't want you to know that sickness you got, as big as it might be now, God can still heal it.
Oh, yes. Yes.
God can still heal it.
Yes.
And you and I need to know the victory. The victory may start off a little. I got my brother here as a testimony. He thanked God for every little bit that God did for him as he walked through these sicknesses.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
I'm a witness to that. Every little bit. I have a sister in here believing God for something, and she's thanking him come to church whenever she can.
Yes, Lord.
Just a little bit.
Right.
I want to thank you for the little healing I got.
Yes.
The little peace I got.
Yes.
Because he can build on that.
Yes.
He didn't come in like a king on a white horse. He came in with his feet dragging on a donkey's coat. Today, I want you to start off with thanksgiving in your heart today. I want you to know you're going to enter that great city of God just like you are today. With what little you got, what little you know, you can enter the kingdom. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Listen, today is a day of thanksgiving today. If that story about the branches being put down before him, if it means anything to us, it's that we praise him because he's all about the little things. Mm-hmm. We praise him because he put food on my table.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
He gave me donuts after church.
Yes, yes.
We got to be thankful.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're dealing with a lot of things, trust me. But we think about the things that he has done.
Yes.
That he has been doing all along.
All along.
Yeah. When you thought you couldn't pay the bill, mm-hmm. you look back at it and it got paid.
Yes, Lord.
When the enemy came at you, oh, let me tell you, he comes. Mm-hmm. When he comes at you like a flood,
yes, Lord.
You weren't overwhelmed. You weren't totally torn apart.
Mm-hmm.
You went through grief. You went through hardship.
Yes.
You went through difficulty. It took time. But you start thanking him for the little things.
Yes.
And then, all of a sudden, you were free, healed, whole, prospering again.
Yeah.
Some of you are going through things right now. But I want you to know, you thank him where you are for the small things.
Yes.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Y'all know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You know, I tell you, if you only knew how much he can do for you from where you are. Just where you are. If you only can thank him for that, just where you are now.
Yeah, yeah.
He's already planning the big thing that you really want.
Yes.
Because you're thankful for the little thing you already got.
Yes.
When you get ready to praise him again in a few minutes, I'm going to ask y'all to come up with a couple of praise songs. I want you to start thanking him for the little things.
Yes.
There you go. Listen, I call this message 100. I want you to have 100.
Yes.
Yes.
You may have one right now, but you're going to get 100.
That's right.
Listen, you start off thanking him for the one.
Yes.
And he's going to raise you up to 100.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm telling you, it's a principle. Turn with me to Psalm 100. Listen. Now, I'm going to tell you how you enter God in praise and worship. You don't enter God just want to hear a good song. You enter God with thanksgiving. You come into church not looking around to see who's here. You come in with thanksgiving. Oh, Lord, I'm thankful. I'm back in the house of the Lord. I'm thankful that I got up this morning, the old people used to say. I'm thankful, Lord. I'm back in church.
Oh, yes.
I thought I'd never make it back, but I'm here.
Hallelujah.
And I'm thankful you brought me through.
Yes.
I'm thankful for the small things you've done.
Yes.
The little things that sometimes I got a big thing I want, I haven't noticed all the little things you've been doing.
Yes.
Today, I want to enter your gates. What? With thanksgiving. Listen. Psalm 100, you read it with me loud. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Say with me, enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. He entered those gates. And the people who knew that he raised Lazarus from the dead and the others who knew who he was, they put these palm branches in his way. And they praised him. And as he entered the gates, they were thankful. Something put thanksgiving in your heart every time you enter the gates of Christ. When you come to church, when you kneel down at night and pray, when you get ready to praise him in the morning, start off with a little thanksgiving. Start looking for all those things to be thankful for. Start looking at all the little things that give you joy. When you just look at it. When my little brother walked in church, I just get joy just came over me.
Oh, yeah.
When I see some of you pressing in, coming to church through great pain and sorrow and struggle, because I know it, I'm thankful for you. I'm thankful for you. Because you didn't hold back. You walked into the gates of God. And you came to give him thanksgiving and praise. Today, when your praise team come on back up, I want you to just give him praise for all the little things. You know, little things. That's something you're going to, dinner you're going back and eat. Thank him for that. And all those big things you want, he's going to give you that too. But I want you to enter his gates with some thanksgiving. Hallelujah. Those beautiful children, thank you for them. Thank you for them. Even if they give you a headache at night trying to get them to bed. Thank you. How many of y'all know how to thank you for a
little?
I want you to do 100 today. I want you to go from wherever you are right now, 5, 6, 7, 8, 50, I want you to go to 100. I want you to imagine that God is with you, so who can be against you? And that he will provide your every need for his riches and glory. And if you ask him for anything, you will receive. But first I gotta start off with thanksgiving. I want you going to Easter Sunday with thanksgiving in your heart. Thankful for the blood. Thank you for redemption. Thank you, Lord, for a place to worship you. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the job I got. I want another one. Thank you, Lord God, for the things I've lost that I did experience. Thank you for them anyway, because they were with me for so long. I thank you for the time things were with me. I thank you for the time my daddy was with me, even if he died when he was 53. I'm thankful for the time he was here.
Yes, Lord, yes.
Thank God for it.
Yes.
Mom and daddy, I thank you for them, Lord, because they brought me here. I'm thankful for them.
Yes.
Y'all know what I'm trying to get at, because it looks like I gotta take my coat off, but y'all look like I'm sleeping. Can you enter in with thanksgiving instead of just grumbling? Mr. McGuffin comes to church blind and with all kinds of other complications. You can't even look at him and tell he got anything, because he's so thankful for what he has.
Come on, guys.
You got all your eyes to see.
Come on.
And you're not even thankful for sight. Sight. I'm waiting for God to give him his back.
Yes.
How many of you gonna thank him for things?
Yes, hallelujah.
When you come on Resurrection Sunday, the 9 o'clock Sunday morning, come with going the whole week with thanksgiving. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Enter that Sunday morning with thankfulness.
Yes.
Okay? Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your son Jesus.
Yes.
For the blood,
yes,
that atoned for me,
yes,
and all my sins.
Yes.
Because you changed me.
Yes.
You changed me. And Lord, I'm thankful that I'm in the house of the Lord this morning. And I come, Lord, with thanksgiving in my heart for all the life you have given me already.
Yes.
For the years I've already lived. For the things I already have. For the people I've already loved. I come into the house of God with thanksgiving for all that you have done for me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You want to hold off on that one?
Okay.
Just so everybody knows. I want you to feel that.
Yeah.
ready to wave the palms in your house when you're doing it. Thank you. Thank you for the house you're living in. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Almighty God bless.